referring to the dismal performance of the BJP in Maharashtra after the Lok Sabha elections, Maharashtra Deputy Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis has offered to resign as the Deputy Chief Minister of Maharashtra. In fact, in a press conference held today afternoon at the party headquarters, he said that he had already spoken with the party leadership and had requested them to release him of the responsibilities of the state government so that he could focus completely on the party organization and focus on the upcoming Vidhan Sabha elections which Maharashtra faces within a few months from now. The reasons for such a statement, clearly the results are the biggest reason. At a time when Maharashtra, the second largest state with 48 seats, second largest only after Uttar Pradesh, saw a dismal performance not just by the BJP but also by the alliance partners, the blame game has already begun. When it comes to the BJP, it garnered just 9 of the 28 seats that it fought on, a clear disappointment for the party. It was the eldest brother in the alliance. It fought on the maximum number of seats. It gave 15 seats to Eknath Shinde, out of which Eknath Shinde as well brought 7 of those seats with almost a 50% strike rate. It is the BJP strike rate which became a disappointment for the party. Ajit Pawar, who fought on 4 seats, could get only 1 seat. The prestige seat of Baramati could not be brought in. Owing to the different aspects with respect to the reasons behind this failure, Devendra Fadnavis held a press conference today after a 2-hour meeting with the core committee members of the BJP Maharashtra state. And after this core committee meeting, he said that several issues affected them quite badly, affected the Mahayuti quite badly. One of them was the onion price rise. The other was the narrative with respect to the change in the constitution. One was also with respect to Muslim consolidation of vote, and then the Maratha reservation issue. All in all, he said, these were the factors because of which the BJP and the alliance partners had to face a backlash. But primarily for the BJP, it is a slap on the face because it fought on more seats than the Congress had, and it got fewer seats than what the Congress could get. While Congress got 13 seats in Maharashtra, the BJP got 9 seats, just one extra than what Sharad Pawar's NCP could garner across the state. And that is why now, owing to all these reasons, Devendra Fadnavis has offered to tender his resignation as the Maharashtra Deputy Chief Minister, saying that it is the party's organization on which he wants to focus now. But the core committee told us that they had already spoken with Devendra Fadnavis and had convinced him to not take such a step, and that the core committee itself would oppose such a move. When we spoke to Ashok Chavan, he said that it was a collective responsibility, and when it comes to elections, just like there is a victory, there is defeat as well. At the same time, the party was keen to highlight that it was only after Jawaharlal Nehru that a government was coming to power for the third consecutive term, and that the BJP along with its allies as an NDA bloc will come to government, will come to power for the third term straight in India, thereby forming a record of sorts. As of now, while Devendra Fadnavis has said that he will resign, the core committee has said that they will not let him resign, and that they have already convinced him. Whether any development will happen with respect to this is something that remains to be seen, but the opposition has slammed this particular move, while Sushma Andhare of the Shiv Sena UBT said that Devendra Fadnavis wants a graceful exit out of this entire mess of the performance of the BJP. By resigning, he is not going to get so. The Congress also reacted, saying that Devendra Fadnavis was an efficient leader, and that the responsibility of this entire performance of BJP should also be fixed upon. So Eknath Shinde has also appealed to the Deputy Chief Minister to not take up such a step, saying that he has been efficiently functioning and that he is required for the smooth functioning of Maharashtra government for the next few months from now on, because within the next few months, Maharashtra faces the assembly elections.